Okay, so what's hitting theaters this week? We have six movies coming out this week, and I don't think I'm familiar, and I haven't done any research yet. So this is one that I didn't have time to do research. I don't actually think I know of any of these six movies coming out this
Let me double check the list that I have. No, I
week.
don't think I have. I've heard of Don't Let Go for some reason. Maybe it's just I'm having.
Just from Jack and Titanic, I'll never let go.
No, I was thinking Frozen.
Oh.
All
All right,
right.
so what's this first one that we have up?
Let's
So,
start with Don't Let Go. Just for
oh,
giggles.
okay.
Just for giggles on there.
All right, let me. All right, don't let go. All right, three, two, one, play.
Hey, Ashley.
Hey, Uncle Jack.
Well, the best thing about your dad being such a screw up is I get to spend time with my favorite niece. Hey, Ashley. Ashley?
I thought the same thing.
Not good.
Don't tell me they killed her.
They did.
I'm so sorry, Jack.
He's a cop, so somebody that he's probably arrested in the past.
I prayed for a second chance to save her.
That's not cool.
I'm getting goosebumps because of that.
Me too.
Oh.
Who is this?
Who do you think it is?
Where are you calling from?
I'm at my house. In my bedroom.
What's the date today?
It's June 25th.
Believe it or not, I'm sitting right here.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
I don't understand.
There's a crime that in your time hasn't yet happened. Your dad's gonna
What's
die.
That old movie?
You know what movie
your mom's
it
gonna
is.
Die.
Frequency!
Yes!
So are
Frequency.
you.
That's what it is. It's a
As
remake of
long as
Frequency.
you're alive, you can change things.
I
Two
love
days to
it!
live, what's that? Just reconstructing the timeline.
Who did it?
We don't know that yet.
There's
you know
people here, there's a white car.
Ashley, turn around and go. Jack,
tell me what's going on.
You're
not gonna die. Not gonna let that happen.
Oh.
All right, I'm not gonna lie. I want to do a double header on that. I want to actually watch Frequency and
I
immediately
do
turn around
too.
and watch that movie because
I
it's
do
the exact
too.
same. Instead of an actual, you know, ham radio that he's using, it's a cell phone, an
And
iPhone.
it's not like, because in Frequency it was years later.
No telling
Yeah.
how long. Well, yeah, it
Yeah,
wasn't that
in the
that.
movie Frequency it was years later
Yeah,
because it
because
was
it was about his
dad.
dad. Yeah.
Yes, but in this one it's only 2 weeks. Oh my God, that looks so
I liked it. I
good.
liked
I
that. Whoever did that
really,
trailer,
really
props
like
to
that.
them as well.
Yes. I mean, I'm glad we started with that one because, geez, I
And
mean,
by the way,
maybe.
yeah, I said don't let go. Maybe you've heard of that. Nope. That was
Nope.
completely
I
just.
haven't heard of that. I didn't know anything
And
about
when you said
that.
that old movie, it clicked with me at the same time, right before you said
Yes.
that. I was just like, ah, what is it called? Because he was a firefighter. I can remember the house. It
Yes,
was mainly blue and
yes.
dark and everything. And oh,
So
yeah.
apparently, when I first started watching it, I was like, oh my God, they killed the whole family. This is going to be revenge. I'm trying to discover this. And then she calls. And I'm like, oh, they're fucking with him. Like,
Yeah, I thought it was
that's
somebody
just so
stole the
wrong.
cell phone
And
and was
then
like,
he
"You
was like,
put my brother
well,
in jail, and this is what I'm gonna do to you." And then he has to go into revenge. I was right there with you.
yeah. And then they completely twisted it around. I'm like,
Yeah, that was
oh,
good. I liked it. I liked it.
I'm really excited for that. That looks really
It looks
good.
fun.
I'll be excited for the reviews. I hope it does well. And I'm sure people will be comparing it to Frequency.
I don't think most people know about Frequency, to be honest with you. I don't think it was a popular movie.
I mean, I don't think it was like you know, a huge success. But anybody who's seen it is going to obviously...
Did you ever hear of Arlington Road or Fallen before me? I think this is frequency is on the same level as those.
Okay. All right. But this this looks amazing.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, good. Props. Oh, goodness.
All right. Okay. Next pick is yours.
Oh, God. What if I pick something that doesn't look as good as... Nothing's going to compare.
I already won today. I already won this week's. Go.
Oh, okay. Let's go with, let's just go with the first one that you sent me. What was the first one? The banana split? What?
Banana splits? Okay.
Yeah, that was the first one that showed up. That actually, yeah, that comes out this week.
Well,
so.
Obviously all of them do. It's called...
Sorry. I think this one comes out technically on Wednesday, so shut your face. But anyways, 3, 2, 1. Play.
I'm gonna start counting down so he doesn't talk shit about me anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
Ooh, good job picking a horror, violence, and gore one. It's right up your alley.
Oh my God,
it's a Five Nights at Freddy's movie!
Yay!
Sweetheart,
we are going to the banana splits.
I might take my daughter.
Sometimes at night, I see the splits riding around in the little cars. Laughing and singing.
Who's excited to see the banana splits?
Yeah! You're gonna hate this.
I'm canceling the show.
Huh? What?
You're gonna hate this.
Hey, kids, put on your happiest faces because the banana split show is about to begin.
Where are the children?
Mom, get out of here.
Time's almost up.
Why are you doing this to me?
Dad, please!
Let me
out! Can they kill the parents?
Now the show can go on forever and ever and ever!
Come on, you fussy son of a...
I just really want your brother's birthday to be perfect.
We're gonna have so much fun!
All right, you've never heard of Five Nights at Freddy's, have you?
No. Did I just watch?
It's that's basically like a version of Five Nights at Freddy's. It was a game that came out as a horror game where the animatronics go crazy and start killing you, and you're a nightly like security guard, and you have to make it till morning. And it became so successful that they made multiple versions, it's on like every platform, and there's like 15 of it. And there's like lore behind it now, so immediately I got it. But the other vibe I got was Killer Clowns from Outer Space. That's the other vibe I got, where it's a fun killing horror movie where it's kind of like enjoyable because it's stupid shit happening. But
it looks like they kill all the parents and keep the kids.
I wanted more horror out of it, to be honest with you. It was a lighthearted Five Nights at Freddy's. Five Nights at Freddy will freak you the fuck out. And honestly, I'm going to recommend that to your husband. That's one of the first games you fucking play. You put the headset on, I will stream it. I want to see the reaction because I liked that. I'm not going to pay money to see it.
No.
But I may actually try to find that for Emma to watch, for my daughter. I think she'll really like enjoy that. It. She was a huge Five Nights at Freddy's fan, even though she couldn't play it because she was scared to play it.
I'm going to say, what are you teaching her? Jeez.
I'm teaching her how to be able to survive. Survive the world. The horrors that lie in it. Nobody needs to be sheltered as a child. But no, that Five Nights at Freddy's mixes with Killer Clowns from Outer Space. That's the vibe I got. Good pick, though.
All right. Yeah, sure. All right, so next.
My pick, I'm going to go with Killerman trailer. The Killerman?
Oh, yeah, that looks like Liam Hemsworth in there.
Ooh.
I know. All right. 3, 2, 1, play.
Are you guys good taking it like this? I don't know how you guys usually pack your money.
We're not gonna need your money.
You've got more in that box than your father has made in his entire life. You wanna risk it on a drug deal?
We're taking it all over.
You sit here all safe and cozy, risk-free.
We walk away with $3 million. Drive!
Whoa!
Where are you?
And look, we can't stay here.
Where are we going?
What is the last thing you remember?
I don't know.
What's your name?
Mo, I think. That's what he's been calling me.
So he has amnesia.
Does bring anything back? How about this?
I'm a drug dealer.
No, you're a money launderer. We took this from dirty cops trying to kill us. And before we unload it, my uncle might decide it's easier to kill us himself than clean up the mess.
You open us up to this, you will finish it.
You don't know who I am?
I don't feel anything. We know that guy.
You got an hour tops to clean up.
We don't pull the trigger unless he has the cash.
Anything goes wrong, you're off the hook.
He's so pretty.
I'm not off the hook when you're dead.
Clock is ticking.
There is no going back.
I feel like I'm running. Why?
So yeah, I haven't heard anything about that at all. Like,
nor have I. I got a little bit of a Grand Theft Auto vibe from it.
Yeah.
But it also, with the amnesia mixed in with it, it doesn't seem like to have a point of pull, if that makes sense. Something to draw me in. Everybody's seen the amnesia situation for so much, you're kind of desensitized to it. The drug deal gone wrong. I am interested a little bit in the story, but it doesn't seem like one I'm dependent on, one I have to know.
Yeah, that's. I kind of get the same thing. Liam Hemsworth is the draw, and then the girl that's in it, she was actually in Orange Is the New Black and Doom Protocol on DC streaming, so she's been doing pretty well. Good for her. Mm-hmm. But the amnesia thing was interesting because obviously he knew something that the rest of his team didn't, and I think that they're trying to like jog his memory and everything. So. It is two storylines we've heard before, drug deal go wrong, amnesia, but it looks okay. I'm not going to see it in theaters, but if it was on TV and I didn't have anything else to watch, I'd probably leave it on.
I'd just put on Fifth Element or One Punch Man, or last night I rewatched Dragon Ball Z Broly movie, which is out.
Oh, yeah.
That was great to rewatch, so I'm going to forget that pretty quick.
Probably. All right,
ladies' choice.
Fantastic.
The Fantastic.
Yeah, not the Fantastic Four.
I know. I as soon as I saw it, I was like, oh.
Nah. All right, 3, 2, 1, play. A lot of rated R movies coming out this week.
Johnny Cage.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Dunbar. Is Hunter Dunbar here tonight?
Stalker.
It's a knockout.
I need to get an autograph. Don't let him do this to me.
I'm a fan.
I'm a number one fan.
Is it difficult to find famous people's houses?
I use my star map app. You have to be careful. I don't want you to be accused of stalking.
Hey, you can't just come to my private residence looking for me. Listen, pal, I don't know how you found me, but I don't ever want to see you in this neighborhood again.
So and it's no idea that was John Travolta the whole time.
Neither did I until they said it. I was like, holy shit, it is. And it's not fantastic, by the way.
Oh.
Fanatic.
Fanatic, sorry. My dyslexia kind of got the best of me there.
And I was right with you. I was like, yay!
Yeah, neither one of us noticed that. Oh, Fanatic, wow. I see Fantastic Four is definitely on our minds. Yeah, so, Fanatic.
I like that.
It looked like a good movie for the right audience. I'm not the right audience. I don't want to see. I really hate movies where people break into my home because I will be the first one to shoot someone. I know. But, like, you break into my home, I will not hesitate. I will shoot whoever breaks into my house.
Of course. You should. But what I'm saying, that seems like a fun escalating adventure. It gave a lot away, obviously. But
obviously. But John Travolta completely got lost in that role.
Fucking loved it.
I love the fact that you can't tell that it was him. Mm-hmm. Like, he was just so... Just so lost in that character.
He seemed familiar, but I would have never guessed. And yeah, that looked fun.
Yeah, well, your idea of fun and my idea of fun are a little bit different there. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
Let's move on. We have Official Secrets.
You want Official Secrets? It's my pick.
Oh, sorry.
I'm gonna go with Saaho.
Okay.
Because I want you to do Official Secrets last, but I want Saaho just because it looks like a foreign film. And last time we had a foreign film, I had no subtitles, and I thought it was a lot of fun.
All right. 3, 2, 1, play.
That sounded like a duck.
That was my cat.
Oh. Mumbai mein 2,000 crore ki chori hui hai. Sutron ke anusar, police ke paas abhi tak koi leads nahi hai.
We should be ashamed of ourselves.
Case a undercover police officer handle kare.
Oh, this is gonna be awesome. This is gonna be awesome.
पहले आने वाले smoking ad की तरह से.
It's gonna be so over the top.
होता है लेकिन visuals बहुत disturbing हैं.
Amrita Nair, crime branch. इसका अगला plan क्या होगा?
तुमने वाजी सिटी के बारे में तो सुना ही होगा जहां क्राइम और गैंगस्टर्स का राज चलता है वहां एक इंपॉर्टेंट लॉकर है
इसकी सिर्फ एक चाबी है
द ब्लैक बॉक्स
वो अगर हमें मिल जाए तो
हड्डी अफ्रीकन भेजेगा
इज इट हाफ इंग्लिश एंड हाफ अनदर लैंग्वेज लाइक व्हाट द
वेलेंस वेलेंस ज्यादा हो गया यू नो समथिंग लाइक
romance?
Haan, romance mein.
Baby, won't you tell me, oh tell me, oh tell me. Baby, won't you tell me so. Baby, won't you tell me, oh tell me.
Hamara rishta din aur raat jaisa hai. Dono ek dusre ke mohtaj hai. Aur ek saath reh bhi nahi sakte.
Ise kehte hai master stroke. Sixer. गली क्रिकेट में तो सब टेंडुलकर है असली टैलेंट वो होता है जो बड़े मैदान के बाहर सिक्सर मार सके
Shut up, it's foreign, Fast and the Furious.
तुम्हें यहाँ मार के कोई फायदा नहीं क्योंकि सब यहाँ है
Oh my god, it's foreign Fast and the Furious. I'm so excited about it. I want to see this. I'm not going to lie.
Really? You don't even like Fast and Furious.
I know, but this looks so... It's like... Oh my god, it's... What is it? It's like they're trying to do something like a Fast and the Furious film, but they do it so over the top that it ends up making fun of the Fast and the Furious movies. I already support what this is, and it's experience it in IMAX. Hold on, I'm changing the back. Where? Come on, pop up. Oh.
Are you gonna do that?
The 4DX? I don't know. 4DX. If it has it at 4DX, I might go see it. I'm gonna be the only Caucasian person there, but I'm really looking forward to it because that looks fun. I'm so hyped. I'm so excited.
You're actually gonna one, spend money on it, and two, a ridiculous amount of money on it.
Well, we'll see if it comes to the 4DX, because 4DX was an amazing experience. But 30th of August, I mean, it's this week. So yes. I'm really looking forward to somehow getting my hands on this. I'm not even gonna close that trailer. I'm gonna keep it up in the background just so I never forget that name.
All right, we got one more trailer.
God, you're not even going to talk about the trailer with the awesome visuals and effects in that?
It's so ridiculous, and I'm like trying to follow what happens, and I'm like reading, and then half of it's in English and half of it's in Spanish, and I'm just like, what's going on? And then there's a romance cut, and then there's like slow motion, and then there's action, and then I don't know what's going on with this movie.
That's why I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I want to see this movie. Oh my goodness. All right. Last one, and this is Official Secrets, or is it Secrets?
Secrets.
All right.
All right. 3, 2, 1, play.
And it's just got language, but it's rated R for language?
Yeah.
That's it?
Every movie is rated R this week.
So they're just going to cuss.
Catherine got
it. But no violence?
I guess.
Blood, gore, drug use, sexual content, none of it?
What were you employed to do?
I translated signals intelligence, and I reported anything of interest to my clients.
You're a spy.
Did you get this email?
The Americans want us to help them get a UN resolution for war.
So, you work for the British government?
No.
No?
This proposed war is historically unpopular.
I work for the British people. I do not gather intelligence so that the government can lie to the British people.
Intelligence may be being manipulated to take this country to war.
I could get you a copy.
You're asking me to collude in a breach of the Official Secrets Act. Some call that treason.
Someone has betrayed their
it's
government.
Doctor Who!
And their country.
You might need our help.
If we do not go public, we would be conceding that no one can ever tell the people when their government is lying.
Your marriage will be interrogated.
My husband had absolutely nothing to do with this.
Doesn't matter.
He's a Muslim.
I'm sorry?
Nope. They're gonna pick you apart.
You chose loyalty to your country over loyalty to your government, your marriage, and yourself. I think that speaks rather highly of you.
Catherine Therese of Gon, you're charged with an offence of the Official Secrets Act.
Do you want to risk it all?
How do you plead?
So I'm getting Snowden.
Yeah.
Right.
You getting that vibe?
Yeah, I'm getting that vibe.
It's basically
which was a great movie.
It's like British NSA.
Yep.
The NSA. That's right.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, that's what I got out of it, and
yeah,
I don't see why it's rated R. And I mean, I can understand the language on there, but there wasn't anything that was incredibly.
Unless we're just missing something in the trailer. But, you know, this comes out this week, so...
I can understand it because it's lies and political pull and threats.
But
and...
still, like, that doesn't give it a rated R. Like, rated R is for, like you said, sexual content and...
No, you can only use, like, the F-bomb at a PG-13, I think, once during a movie.
Yeah.
So maybe they actually say the word fuck a few more times than once. So it forced it into a rated R version. And honestly, most movies, they don't want to go to R unless that's the audience they're appealing to. They want to stay the PG-13, but yeah. If they,
but this is obviously a very adult story.
If it was only language, then those cuss words must have been very like profound when they do it. Yeah. So they're like, you can change it to that's crap. They're like, no, we're keeping fuck. Yeah. So they're like, give us the rated R, let's roll with this. It seems interesting. I'm not dead set on it, but it's definitely something I'd like to be able to see how we've seen the Snowden, we've seen the American side. Yep. We live through the news reports and this, that, and the other, and everybody pointing fingers. I don't really hear much about the across the pond. I'd like to be able to maybe watch this for more just knowledge on it, but it all depends on how accurate it really is. And always. You can't trust movies when it comes to that stuff, but where else are you going to trust stuff either? You can't really trust whatever news channel you fucking watch. I trust Reddit more than I trust more than anything else.
I feel like I do the same thing.
Because Reddit is the community of people, and if one person's a douche, then everybody's going to call that douche out and then point out the facts and links to back it up. Nobody else is held to those standards, and they're not even held to those standards. They do it out of their own backing of their opinion. So,
So that's six movies coming out this week.
Correct.
I think we both can agree that the number one choice on both of our lists is Don't Let Go.
Saaho? Oh, Don't Let Go.
Not Saaho. Don't Let Go.
Okay, yeah. I'm right there with you. Don't Let Go looked great. I'm telling you, I'm gonna see Saaho. I don't even know if you pronounce it that way, but I'm just telling you right now, with homework being involved and the qualification is the one person has to watch it, you may have to know what the story is at some point. Maybe down the road, maybe I'll save it in my back pocket.
Save it. I don't want to go pay money.
Banana Splits, I wouldn't mind showing that trailer to my daughter and see what she thinks, because she, like I said, Five Nights at Freddy's fan. The Fanatic, I want to see a little bit more of that. I want another trailer. I want to hear reviews on it.
It comes out this week, so you're not going to get another. I mean, unless
that's true. I'll maybe hear some reviews on it as well.
Yeah, the reviews. Killerman. In the reviews.
Yeah. Official Secrets. Don't Let Go. Saaho.
Yeah, mine would be Don't Let Go and Official Secrets. Those would be my top two. The other ones, I could pass on.
Mm-hmm.
The Fanatic. That one would be
fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So, out of those six, I mean, what are you guys going to see? Are you seeing anything new this weekend, or are you going to go see something that's already been out?
I'd really like to know if somebody's hyped about Saaho like I am. Am I just shaking your head? It looks action packed from beginning to end. It's like the next Avengers. That's what it's going to be, right?
Oh my God. You just shut your face.
I'm going to watch the doubleheader, that followed just by the Dora Explorer movie. Make my weekend right there.
Not at all. Jeez.